this video we do a quick tool review on the three-axis display and some linear scales. This is because this display is new to Banggood and it has some different features to the other display that they sell. And we also have a look at the glass scales, which have some improvements to them over previous versions. So let's have a look.
Today I have an update on the digital readouts and the display unit. These are some new items that Banggood are selling. They're made by a different manufacturer, but these have a slight difference. I thought I'd show you the difference so you know. We'll start off with the digital readout display. So in this kit you get the normal plastic cover for the display, some cable ties, earth wire, the bracket to hold the display to the machine or the wall, bag of nuts and bolts, the manual, the power cable, the tube that holds the display to the bracket, and of course the display. Now this display, very similar to the original ones that they sold, it's made by a different manufacturer. The only noticeable difference is they've moved the X, Y and Z zero in and X, Y and Z inputs all together next to each other. We still have the 8 positions for machining a radius on the inside and the outside. They still have all the other functions, and they've made the keyboard for inputting separate. So what you get with it, you get the cable once more, not a UK plug, but with this one I have an adapter that they sent me which fits and converts it to a UK plug. So on the back, you on off switch, power input, earthing point, and your X, Y and Z readouts. Let's put some power to it, see what it looks like. It's a green display, it's clear. Instructions that come with it, digital readouts, it's very good, it's in English. It goes through the step by step how to do the different things. And that's a 50 page booklet. So if I go through some of the features on this one, X, Y and Z zero will zero your X, Y and Z scale. ABS is absolute, or you can change it to incremental. This X, Y and Z in blue is to select the axis, then you can put a distance in and enter that for the axis. So the yellow ones zero it, the blue ones let you input a figure. We'll go through the list in the book. You have your inch to metric switch here, which converts from metric to imperial, and you still get 4 decimal places on imperial. 3 metric, now that's different to the one I've got, because imperial I'll get 5 points, so they may have just rounded it up. Half is your centering function, so you can zero it, move to a position and tell it to halve it, and it will halve the distance. The SDM switch is the subdatums. The instructions on the website for this says there are 200 subdatums, but on this one you can see there are 499 subdatums. So if I enter that as a subdatum, it does have a lathe function. It has a filter display. That's when if you've got vibration and these are flickering, you can filter that out to give you the average. You have your bolt hole on a pitch circle. Choose that one. a bolt hole on a line, which is this one, so you can divide the line into a number of holes, so we can do a circle or a line.
You have your arc processing for processing 8 different types of radius.
And then you've got a normal calculator function.
Just got an eye looking at XYZ.
Temporary quick, leave processing temporary to return to normal display.
So one of the problems that somebody had with the other display was it only held 200 subdatums. This display holds 499 subdatums.
The next thing's the scales. You get a cover, bag of nuts and bolts. You get some shims, which is unusual, which you don't normally get, some about 10,000 shims. And you also get some cable, plastic cable holders to hold the wire out of the way, which you don't normally get. You get that type of bracket with it. The first thing you'll notice with this scale is it doesn't have cable ties over here holding this part down. What they've done is fix a red piece of plastic in there, which is screwed into the end, just to separate it from the scale and stop it sliding around, which is useful. And the reason why that's useful is when you have cable ties clipped around here to hold this down, what I found is you can't bolt this to the machine because the cable ties are in the way. So you have to undo the cable ties, then this is floating. You can see that on the reading head it says something in Chinese, and it says, please remove the red gasket and use it. I think what they mean is remove the red gasket before you use it. On the side of the scale, some more information. It has the range. This is a 200 linear scale. They call it a ruler. So it can go up to 200 millimetre. It has the date it was produced, which was November 2019. So you can see it's new stock and not been sitting on the shelf for years. And it has some more information here about the company. The other thing about this one is you can see here, this has blades to stop the dirt getting in, but another set further down, so that they've got a double set of silicon blades in there. Now these scales, they say this is sealed with a special sealant to prevent moisture and liquids getting into the head. Everything else is like a standard scale. Here's the scale working. So if I move the scale forward and backwards, it works okay. I zero it there. This way it's positive, the other way it's negative. You can alter that in the program. So all I want to show you is the differences. So by putting this red plastic in, it makes it a lot easier to fit and adjust. It gives you the space that you need to have there between your brackets, so you know it's all set up properly. Then the last thing you do is take the spacer out once you've got the brackets and the part mounted to your machine. Everything else is standard. Just looks different, and as I say, the main thing for some people would be the 499 subdatums. There's no tool register as such, or tool datums set. They're just subdatums for, you could use them for tools or whatever you like. Well, that's it for this tool update. Hope that was useful.